So look at this formula. In the formula, it is given that the acceleration due to gravity of the earth, g is equal to gm by r square. So g is, small g is acceleration due to gravity, and capital G is the universal gravitational constant, m is the mass of the earth, and r is the radius. So now from this formula, you can see that g is not depend, the value of small g is not depends on the mass of the object, but it is depends on the mass of the planet. Okay, so let's look back in time. Like in 16th century Italy, it was generally assumed that the acceleration of a freely falling body would be proportional to its mass. That is, a 10 kg object was expected to accelerate 10 times faster than a 1 kg object. This the ancient Greek philosopher Aristotle included this rule in his first book of mechanics, but it was challenged by Galileo Galilei. In the year in between 1564 to 1642, Galileo dropped two objects, two heavy balls of different masses, or you can say unequal masses, from the Leaning Tower of Pisa and proved Aristotle's theory wrong. Galileo in general regarded as the world's first scientist. So today we'll see one video. In the video, the same experiment they repeated with a ball and feather in the NASA laboratory, and this experiment also proved that Galileo's theory was exactly correct and Aristotle's theory was not correct. Okay, so let's start the video.
This is NASA's Space Power Facility near Cleveland, Ohio, and it is the world's biggest vacuum chamber. It's used to test spacecraft in the conditions of outer space, and it does that by pumping out the 30 tons of air in this chamber until there are about 2 grams left. And it's kind of got an eccentric construction, which is part of its history. It was built in the 1960s as a nuclear test facility to test nuclear propulsion systems, and that meant that they built it out of aluminium to make the radiation easier to deal with. Aluminium is not the best thing, the strongest material to build a vacuum chamber out of. So they built an outer concrete skin, which is part radiation shielding and part an external pressure vessel, so that this thing can take the force that's present on the outside when it's pumped out to the conditions of outer space. Galileo's experiment was simple. He took a heavy object and a light one, and dropped them at the same time to see which fell fastest. Now in this case, the feathers fell to the ground at a slower rate than the bowling ball because of air resistance. So, in order to see the true nature of gravity, we have to remove the air. It takes 3 hours to pump out the 800,000 cubic feet of air from the chamber.
Okay, we dropped 2 millitorr in the last 30 minutes.
But once it's complete, there's a near perfect vacuum inside.
6104 manual, 10% open. Station 1, go for drop. PCV 30-1, pressure set point at 240 psi. We are go for drop.
10, 9, 8. 7, 6, 5, 4. Cameras on. 2, 1. Release.
Mm-hmm. Look at that.
They came down exactly the same. Wow.
Look.
Watch right there. Look at how they hit right there.
Exactly.
You're back on the side.
Exactly the same.
Feathers don't move. Nothing.
Look at that. That's just brilliant.
Isaac Newton would say that the ball and the feather fall because there's a force pulling them down, gravity. But Einstein imagined the scene very differently. The happiest thought of his life was this.
The reason the bowling ball and the feather fall together is because they're not falling. They're standing still. There is no force acting on them at all.
He reasoned that if you couldn't see the background, there'd be no way of knowing that the ball and the feathers were being accelerated towards the Earth. So he concluded they weren't.